X-ray diffraction is a non-destructive analytical technique. It is mainly used in identification of crystalline materials. In an X-ray diffraction experiment, a sample is placed at the center of the instrument and a beam of X-rays is passed through the sample. The sample absorbs these X-rays and re-emit them in the form of new X-rays. The re-emitted radiation is recorded by the detector in the form of a graph. The peak observed in the XRD spectrum tells about the atomic structure of the sample. Each crystalline material has a different atomic structure, therefore gives different XRD spectrum. In crystalline material, crystals are composed of regular arrangement of atoms, and each atom is composed of a nucleus surrounded by its electrons. When X-rays hit an atom, its energy is absorbed by the electrons. Since this is not enough energy to be released in the form of heat or other form, electrons re-emit this energy in the form of a new X-rays, but the same energy as the original. This process is called elastic scattering. The phenomena by which X-rays are reflected from the atoms in a crystalline solid is called diffraction. The intensity of scattered rays depends on the scattering power of individual atoms, which in turn depends on the number of electrons in an atom. X-rays are high energy light with a repeating period called wavelength. The wavelength of an X-ray is similar to the distance between atoms in a crystal. Therefore, when X-rays interact with each other, a special interference effect occurs. If the waves are in same phase, the waves combine together to increase the light intensity. This is called constructive interference. If the waves are out of sync, the signal is destroyed. This is called destructive interference. In order for constructive interference to occur, the scattered waves must be in phase. Now, constructive interference can only occur if the incident and scattered wave travel equal distance. Since we know that in a crystal, the repeating arrangement of atoms forms distinct planes, and these planes are separated from each other by a well-defined distance known as d spacing. When X-rays fall on atomic planes, X-rays are scattered by the regularly spaced atoms. When X-rays fall on the top layer, then both incident and scattered ray travel same distance. But when X-rays fall on internal layer, both incident and scattered ray travel some extra distance. Similarly, if the X-rays fall on the third layer, both rays have to travel some more distance. This extra distance traveled by X-ray is known as path difference. Because of this path difference, it is not necessary that scattered rays will interfere constructively. So the only possibility when scattered rays can interfere constructively is that when incident and scattered ray travel a whole number. Suppose if the path difference is equal to one wavelength, so in that case both the rays will be in same phase because half of the distance is traveled by incident ray and half of the distance is traveled by scattered ray. Similarly, if the path difference is equal to two wavelength, so in that case also both the rays will be in same phase, as one wavelength distance will be traveled by incident ray and one wavelength distance will be traveled by scattered ray. So, for constructive interference, path difference is equal to n lambda, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. The incident ray interacts with an atom at an angle theta and reflects at a certain angle. In case of reflection, both incident and scattered or reflected angles are same. Therefore, angle between ACB will be theta, and so for the triangle ADB. So in triangle ACB, sine theta is equal to CB upon AB, and we know that AB is equal to D. So CB is equal to D sine theta. Similarly, in triangle ADB, sine theta is equal to DB upon AB, and AB is equal to D, so DB is equal to D sine theta. Now replace CB and DB by D sine theta in path difference equation. So finally we get a new equation, that is 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. This equation is known as Bragg's equation. So Bragg's law states that diffraction will occur only if angle of incidence is equal to angle of scattering and the waves constructively interfere with path difference of a whole number of wavelength. So with the help of Bragg equation, we can directly measure wavelength of X-rays, d-spacing of crystals and diffraction angle.